Here in Florida, we're surrounded by the Atlantic Ocean and the Gulf of Mexico, where the ocean is a source of inspiration for many. We talk to some of the women in Florida that are pursuing careers in marine science and find out what inspires them.
I think science allows you to be more creative, and I get to sit down and kind of like think of maybe ways outside of the box, things that aren't in the literature.
What I really like is being able to discover new things that you didn't initially realize might be there.
There's a lot of problems on our coast that are increasing as human population increases, and for me, I wanted to be part of the solution.
What I like the most about science is I really love learning. I love to just immerse myself in understanding why things are happening.
I always had a natural interest for the ocean, but learning even more about it and about all the other things except for the fish and the birds and the whales and the dolphins, I found out that there are so many things that we just don't know about. And I felt that being a part of the edge of knowledge, I felt personally that I could make more of a difference, maybe focusing on what we don't know.
Well, I always loved the ocean, and even though I grew up in Central Virginia and I didn't have easy access to the ocean, but I didn't really know that I wanted to be a scientist until college.
I think I would have wanted to be a marine scientist from the beginning because I grew up on a sailboat in the Caribbean, and so the ocean was my backyard. But actually, up until I was a junior in high school, I thought I was going to go into business because both my parents were business people. And then I had this incredible class my senior year of high school with a marine biology teacher who took us out on field trips to seagrass beds and to coral reefs. And even though they're around you all the time, you see them differently through someone else's eyes. And that really made me change my entire focus and move into science, so that I went to college to get a biology degree and kept going from there.
The deal was really sealed for me in terms of marine science through a Girl Scout trip. So I've been a Girl Scout my whole life, from starting off as a kid and even now involved as an adult. And I did a Girl Scout trip to North Carolina where we were working on the Topsail Island sea turtle nesting program. And part of what we were doing there was monitoring the sea turtle nests. And I actually got to see a nest of baby sea turtles hatch out when I was in high school and learn all about them and poor survival rates and things like that. And that for me was the moment that I knew this was amazing and this was something that I wanted to work on.
I think that's my favorite thing about the ocean, is there's so many things that we don't know, and there's so many things that you can discover on your own. Just about the ocean is like really cool to me because it's one of those places where there's room for everyone.
The ocean is 3/4 of our planet. It's so huge, almost unimaginably huge, and we still have explored so little of it. So who knows what might be in the ocean that could help people, you know, like medicinal compounds or pharmaceuticals, things like that. But also the ocean helps to regulate our atmosphere and provide a lot of the oxygen we breathe, and it has all these benefits that a lot of people don't think about. So it actually is really important, and in turn, something that you do, you know, if you happen to drop a plastic bottle on the ground, that can still flow into a small creek, which will flow into a river, which will flow into the ocean. So just as the ocean can impact us, we can actually impact the ocean, even if we're nowhere near it.
Even if you've never seen it, the ocean touches every part of your day. You know, if you've ever eaten fish, if you put on makeup, since a lot of it has compounds that come from seaweeds, there's just parts of the ocean that are interacting with you every day.
Even if you've never been to the ocean, if you've never seen it, or if you don't feel like it affects you, it really does affect you. The ocean is an important part of regulating our climate and weather patterns, especially here in Florida. So it affects you on a daily basis, even if you don't realize it. And then also, a lot of our food comes from the ocean. Even if you don't like fish or if you don't eat crabs or oysters, a lot of other people do, and that's an important part of our economy, and a lot of people's jobs depend on the ocean. And tourism is an important part of the economy in our state. So the ocean is an extremely important driver, both of the environment and the economy. So even if you've never been there, it touches you every day.
You have to sort of expect that some days you're going to have to do things over and over, and it might be tedious and frustrating, and you still have to just do it to get the answer you want. In a way, it's a lesson because science never works the first time, or very rarely.
One of my weakest points was math, and it was kind of hard because I really wanted to be a scientist, so I really needed to learn at least the minimum of math. So that was kind of something that I need to put a lot of effort on that. And also, like a marine biologist, you need a lot of chemistry. And I always felt that I wasn't enough in chemistry. Till finally I realized that I don't have to work alone. In science, you work with other people.
For me, one of the challenges has always been deciding what to focus on. I'm interested in all avenues of science. There's so many unanswered questions out there, and I had a really hard time deciding exactly what I want to do, and I still feel like I change my mind pretty frequently because there's a lot of exciting unanswered questions out there.
So there are obviously many challenges about being a scientist. Once you start your education, there are many times when you have to figure out if this is really what you want to do, and you have to keep your enthusiasm, because it gets really hard because there are so many things that you need to learn. But I think my biggest fear, because I have always been very much a perfectionist, and I always thought that I did well in school when I was little, but even though you are still at the edge of knowledge when you do science and you do research, so there will be things that do not pan out exactly the way that you thought they would. And so that to me is definitely one of the most frustrating part of being a scientist, is when you cannot achieve the goals that you wanted to, because you cannot get the samples or get to the area that you really did want to go. But all of those things are very quickly just swept away when you do succeed. So for me, one of the best experiences that I've ever had doing deep sea science is being on the deep sea submersible, the Alvin. And being in the Alvin was incredible because you learn about all these things in the textbooks that you just simply cannot comprehend. And when you're in a submersible and you're going through the ocean depths and the water column, and you get to the sea floor, you see all the animals you learn about, you see all the bioluminescence, like fireworks in the water column. And so all of the bad days and all of the challenges are very quickly quickly go away because there are so many good days in science.
Have a passion for something, especially science, you can do it. Ask questions, ask more questions. If it's something you're interested in, you maybe talk to your parents or somebody in the community and definitely see if that's something that you can get involved in.
As marine biologists, oftentimes work as a group, work as a team, and so definitely keeping that in mind that, your work is awesome, but realizing that it's also one of several other studies and other priorities. And so I think if you're pursuing or considering a career in this field, definitely realizing that there's very much a team endeavor in what we do, and just being willing to be a team player in all that you do.
The advice I would give to middle schoolers that want to be in science is, first of all, that's really great that you're already interested in something, because a lot of people don't know what they're interested in and later on, so that's already really special, and that means that it's probably something you should continue and explore on. Because I would definitely say read as much as you can, read about things that excite you, read about things that you don't know much about yet, and just know that it's already really cool that you know that you like science. So that's, you're already in the first step in the right direction.
To ask a lot of questions, and one of the most useful is why. And not just of other people, but of yourself. Now, I'd like to say I had this great plan, except that I really didn't, but I feel like I blundered into exactly my dream job without knowing what it was until I sort of, looked at it in retrospect.
Don't give up. If you are a girl, or even a boy, that is dreaming big and is dreaming wild, and somebody is telling you that you can't, tell that person to stop, to let you dream big, to dream wild, and don't give up. Follow your dreams, follow your heart, and do what you think is going to make you happy, because at the end, that'll make you a better citizen, a better person, and a happy one.
Advice that I would give to myself, if I could go back in time and tell my 8-year-old self something, I would say that science can be challenging, but that adds to the reward, because if it's difficult, it's probably worth doing. And you know, science is one of those things that once you get into it, you get really deeply engaged and involved in it, and you start to see the rewards of all of that hard work. And that is so rewarding, and I would just say definitely stick with it. And the other thing is, science will put you in rooms with a lot of people who are extremely intelligent, and I would say know that you belong in that room with those people. Everyone feels like they don't know what they're doing at some time, even if they don't admit it. And I would say that if you're feeling that way, it's totally normal and it's part of learning science.
Just as there are a wide variety of marine habitats in Florida, there are many different types of people engaging in marine science. Each one has a unique story, and each one brings a special set of skills with them. There's room for everyone in marine science, whether your interests are in chemistry, biology, math, or physics. All of these fields are needed to understand our beautiful marine ecosystems. Won't you join us?